This is FinTech Futures at Sibos, and I'm joined by Hans Tesla. How are you?
I'm fine, Paul. Thank you.
Excellent. How are you enjoying the conference so far?
Yes. Well, if you mean, are you tired? Yes, I am. So if that's part of the enjoying it, then the answer is yes. That implies that there is a lot of traffic, so to speak.
Excellent, excellent. So just to get started, then, we'd like to give a quick introduction to yourself and your role.
Yeah, so my name is Hans Tesla. I'm the executive director of the Banking Industry Architectural Network, also known as BIAN. We are a not-for-profit association, so we don't sell anything. We have members, and the members, they all collaborate to create architecture models that can be implemented by banks. And the mission statement of BIAN is to solve the integration issues for the bank. And we started that journey in 2008.
Excellent, excellent. And one of the things you've been working on quite a lot recently has been the Coreless Banking Framework. Can you explain a little bit more about that?
Yeah, so I have to do one step back. Mm-hmm. So we were focusing primarily in the early days on the integration inside the bank. So how do I add additional functionality to an existing IT system? And then maybe 6-7 years ago, all of a sudden APIs came up, and everybody wants to connect with the outside world, with the fintechs and the Alipays and so on and so forth. So we were moving into the API space. So for a standards body, there was quite a bold step. So all of a sudden we were creating digital assets instead of PowerPoint and Word documents and so on and so forth. Mm-hmm. And when we had those APIs, then the buying board of directors asked the question, can we then use those APIs again to solve the internal integration issue? So that was the question. And then we came up with the concept of the coreless bank. And everybody can coreless bank, a bank without a core system. So especially the core banking providers think, okay, where is our business model? So, but the good news for them is that we cannot do it today. So we think that it will be maybe in 5-10 years the possibility if the technology allows it. So we are now more in a sort of hybrid form for coreless. So what we did, we say what a bank is worried about primarily is vendor lock-in. So they have a system and they can't get out of it anymore. So they are there for decades. And if we can create a sort of plug and play environment, that you say I have a great KYC solution or I have a great loan solution. So how do I plug them in an easy way? So that was the underlying idea. And so we started two proof of concept to prove that we could do it. And then we came into the issue that each of those bits and pieces speak their own language. And then the question is, how are we going to solve that language issue? Because if you do that as a bank and you need to make the translation each time from all the different vendors, then it doesn't speed up the whole of the process. So we created a tool that we call the message model. And you say, okay, I have the BIAN standard and I have, for instance, Salesforce. And then I compare BIAN with Salesforce and then I decide what I like best. So I am Bank A. So I create the Bank A data schema, so to speak, so the language. And then Salesforce, and then the next one comes in, Savin is an example, one of our members. So we add Savin to the existing one. So I create my own internal language based on the APIs that allows me as a bank to go to a best and breed environment. And then gradually diminish the core system, make it smaller and smaller and smaller, so it's only at the end maybe a book of records. But that is the underlying model.
Excellent, excellent. And you do a lot of work with some of the bigger banks in the industry, so like JP Morgan Chase, HSBC, among many others. Can you give us some of the insight into the work you've been doing with them and how they've been maybe looking to it?
So we are a member-driven association, so that is one. So it's not that I say, okay, let's do coreless. JPMC is a great example. They were the drivers of the second POC, and they, when they try to implement it inside the bank, they came into that issue of the different languages, data schemas, and they said we needed to create that message modeler tool. So they engaged one of their partners and they said to the partner, can you build it? And then so they built the tool under the supervision of JPMC, and then JPMC said, okay, now we donate everything to BIAN. Similar with the first one was run by PNC, an American bank. They did the same. So we take all the effort, we do all the thinking, we bring all the partners together, and then when it's ready, we donate it to buy it. And that's the way we operate. So banks or vendors, partners do have an idea, and then they materialize that, making resources available, developers, architects, program managers, and so forth, to create the content that will be then for the benefit of all the buying members.
Excellent. So moving forward then, do you see composable banking then becoming the norm in the industry?
Yes. So Gartner always discusses about the composable enterprise, and if you want to create a composable enterprise, you need to have a composable architecture. And if you have a composable architecture, then you can have, let's say, composable IT elements. And the building blocks that we created, let's say, since 2008, without knowing it, so to be quite honest, are those composable building blocks. Today we call them containerized. Yeah, we knew in 2008 the word container, but we saw them on a ship, and we didn't make the relationship we do today with containerized. So I would say, and of course that's not fair by accident, but it's not of course by accident, our model is the, let's say, the ideal way to start your componentized bank.
Excellent. So you've recently released some new research with IBM as well, on the hurdles to digital transformation. So what did you find them were the main kind of challenges for that?
Well, the challenges are, yeah, there are several challenges, of course, but what we saw that to become successful, to become a successful enterprise, you need to start with a decent architecture. You need to know where you're going to. So if And then you must stop thinking that you can do everything by yourself. So you need to create an ecosystem with partners. It could be fintechs, but it could be other banks, it could be standard bodies, it could be universities, you name it. And then use that joint thinking power to create what you want to do. And if you stick to a standardized model, then you can also have much more traction with all those parts, because they recognize the model and they say it's not a proprietary model, so we can adjust to it. And then for each of the topics, you need to create focus teams. So they are focusing on a topic, but they should, the solution of that topic should be within the boundaries of the overarching architecture. Otherwise, you create spaghetti that you will never can untangle. So you have then, I call it designer spaghetti. It's state of the art, but it's still a spaghetti structure. So those are some of the bits and pieces that makes organizations successful.
Excellent. So just to finish off then, what is Byron currently working on at the moment? Are there any new developments that you can tell us about?
So we are working on several things. So first we need to complete the model more, so there could always be more in-depth content. Especially our data model is 70%, so it has to become to 100%. We are aligning it as much as possible with ISO 20022, so that makes the usage easier. We also are bringing new tools to the membership at the first. That makes it easier to understand the model and easier to implement the model and adjust it to your own needs. And we are on the edge of a new callers initiative that will be more more complicated than the existing one. And the idea of the bank, but I cannot reveal the name yet, is that they are not going to do the proof of concept for doing the proof of concept, but they want to take it into production. So they say we want to build something, and when it's finished, we deploy it. So that is an additional challenge. Yeah? So that is so we have to be more precise in what we are going to deliver.
Excellent, exciting times then. Well, thank you so much for joining us, Hans.
Yeah, it's a pleasure. Thank you, Paul.
Thanks.